The current political atmosphere has made it hard for the larger part of Ugandans to appreciate that COVID-19 is real. But those that have come face to face with COVID-19 now know the importance of following the standard operating procedures.
At about 10:40, they told us that he had died. Stopped breathing, heart stopped pumping, brain dead, he was gone.
Dr. Francis Chitaka Jr. lost a father to COVID-19 on the 12th of September 2020, while Merida and her one-year-old baby and Shadrach were admitted at Mulago National Referral Hospital for treatment this year, in October and August respectively, after testing positive for COVID-19.
And he says, Shadrach, they found out you have the virus. I was actually surprised because I was okay. I actually told him, I'm okay. How come I have the virus? He's like, no, you're positive.
My husband was tested positive and he was admitted in Mulago. That's how I also discovered that I had COVID-19.
This ailment has affected the way they each look at life now.
At the beginning, it appeared like it was a disease very far away in Europe, maybe for the white man, and blacks were resistant because of the sun and other things. But I tell you, COVID is here.
I think people should know that without the symptoms, that doesn't mean you can't have the virus. You can have the virus and can even stick on you. And actually, that's what really perplexed me, the fact that I didn't witness any symptoms, but still I kept on being positive consecutively. That is what puzzled my head.
Because of the stigma, when you develop normal cough and flu, what comes in your mind is maybe COVID has come back again. But when it's actually cough and flu.
Much as some countries have started administering the COVID-19 vaccine, Uganda still has to wait till we can purchase or manufacture our own. According to the World Health Organization, as of 17th December 2020, Uganda COVID-19 infections stood at 29,361, with 225 deaths and over 10,000 recoveries. Wadulo Mark Arnold in Kampala.